Whoa. Now, humans have had domesticated animals or been domesticating animals for a long time. And one of the things that I think we figured out early on was that genetic diversity was a pretty big deal. If your gene pool gets a little too close, or the branches on the tree are a little too close together, you know, animals end up with abnormalities and reproductive issues, things like, you know, calves with two heads, that kind of stuff. You know, a lot of that goes back toward genetics that are too similar. And people are no different, I guess I could say.
It's essentially preventative.
And in the wild, you know, there's ways that deer, young bucks will disperse to new areas and things like that to keep that genetic pool from becoming too tight, animals from being all related. But our deer are in a pen. So how does a deer farm keep bringing new genetics in without having to buy new bucks every year? So one of the ways that we're able to use different bucks and add genetics to our herd is through artificial insemination, or AI, as you hear it called. That's common in the cattle industry. We've done it with cattle for years, and it's common in the deer industry as well. It's a little bit different, but Kansas is known for cedars, and we're going to use cedar. So the process looks something like this. You put a hormone, a controlled release hormone device, into the deer, which keeps it from cycling for a certain amount of time. And then when you pull that hormone out, it's the hormone is progesterone. When you pull that out, that kind of signals the female, the doe's reproductive system, to continue and cycle. And what folks have figured out is if you pull it out and wait a very specific amount of time later, give a small amount of another hormone, it brings the cycling period of these deer and narrows it. So you end up with a lot of deer that cycle at about the same time. And with that, you're able to breed those deer artificially using semen from deer all over the country. Quite frankly, we have a facility. We don't have a facility. All of our product is stored at a facility in liquid nitrogen. They ship it to us. We put it in our nitrogen tank, and then we use it on the deer. Now, again, I've done this with cattle for a long time, but it is a little bit different with deer. The insert is different. The timing is a little bit different. And then, of course, you've got to deal with a wild animal. So the working of the deer is a little different. But we've got everything ready. So we've got the cedars. We've got the gun that you use to put it in. We are going to give them a kind of preventative antibiotic. We've got disinfectant. The cedars are sterile, but the gun, you know, gets shared between animals. So you definitely want to disinfect that gun. Clean it and disinfect it. We've got lubricant that makes the insertion of it much easier. Gloves, you know, everything we should need. Now we just got to get the deer in. So that's the next step, is get all the animals in, get the help here, and we're going to get to it. Go on. Go. Go. There you go. Come on. Oh.
She's one of the ones that comes running to a bucket. It's funny how they.
Whoa.
Here, take your mind off.
Okay, don't.
Spit it back out.
Come on, take another one.
Take a third one. All right,
let's get her moving forward.
Weird sound.
Okay.
There.
Hopefully it doesn't squeeze out of that too bad. Step in there or whatever.
So the process of AIing, we get options to use genetics from stuff that's not on our farm that A, we don't have to be able to afford, and B, don't have to keep. So if you just use your own, the same genetic lines, genetic diversity, you don't want to marry your sister. It's the same idea. Well, most people don't. Same idea with deer. Or cattle or whatever.
Easy.
This is the tamest deer we have, by the way.
Barking deer.
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna hit the gate.
Alright, you can let her out.
Get this first.
Easy.
She's okay. Okay.
Yeah, she's got
that. Okay, it looked like it was bleeding, but it's scarred over.
All right, so tell me again what the purpose of all this is.
All right, so the first process in artificially breeding, if you're gonna sync up the, well, for pretty much deer, is syncing up their heat cycles. So that's, I'm putting in a what's called a CIDR, it's an acronym for something, that basically keeps them from cycling. Their body thinks that they're pregnant, essentially. So we'll put those in today, and then in a couple of weeks we'll take them out, and when you pull that, the fast dropping progesterone, which is the drug in the implant, causes their body to cycle and subsequently ovulate. So that's the idea. Then so we pull them out, and then roughly 65 hours later they should be ovulating. You You can bring them at that point.
And what's in that injection?
So this is, I don't know that they need it, but this is an antibiotic that a lot of people will give. This year, it might actually be necessary because it's so dry. There's so much dust blowing around. I don't want anything getting pneumonia or anything else, but it's essentially preventative. So just look and make sure there's no major injuries anywhere. Easy, 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 easy.
How long do those deer stay in?
A couple of weeks. If you leave them in too long,
Hold on, let me open the gate.
Okay. If you leave them in too long, I'm not a biologist, but I think the follicle or the egg or whatever that's been in the body can get too old. But you have to leave it in long enough so that say this deer was in heat today, you have to leave it in long enough for its system to recover and be ready to continue its cycle in a couple of weeks. Ready? Looking at a spot or something?
No, it looked like a spot there.
Yeah,
it's an old one.
Short. Oh yeah, that's. Go out.
I can do that.
You're looking the wrong way. Ready?
Yep. When is the normal time of year for the fallow deer rut, also known as breeding season, in the Northern Hemisphere? Fallow deer breeding season can run any time from September through February in the Northern Hemisphere. However, it usually starts during October and only lasts about a month. Breeding season is triggered by environmental factors, mainly the change in the amount of daylight in a 24-hour period. This is why fallow deer are known as short-day breeders.
Okay.
Not quite.
Go, go, go.
Through now. Last one?
Last one.
Cool. I was going to say it's gone smoothly, but I don't want to say that yet.
Okay, you ready?
Ready.
Easy.
There, get a little bit farther forward. I think they're less likely to come out the back. But.
Easy, 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 easy.
Yeah, we're being shut.
It is.
Here. Whoa, whoa, easy, easy. Easy, easy, easy.
Started with 13 cedars, ended with zero, so we must have got all of them.
How do you know if you're getting the right
open? Well, you go up first. And that should bypass the bladder. And then it's kind of a feel thing. I'm going to say this doe probably didn't fawn last year because I could really tell the difference. Mm-hmm. The ones that did and the ones that didn't.
What would happen if you got it in the bladder?
It's not going to be effective, but it won't hurt them. As long as we get it back out because it's disinfected and sterile already. So... And I'm disinfecting the gun or applicator, whatever, between.
You gave him a shot.
I gave her a shot already.
Okay.
Disinfecting the gun between animals.
Open.
So. Last one going out.
Not yet, anyway.
I hear it walking.
Okay. I'm gonna let you guys wrap up, clean up, and I'm gonna go toss one to the other.
Okay.
Here she goes.
Yep. Nice.